Flying cars have been a dream of tech enthusiasts and regular people alike for a long time. Countless sci-fi movies, TV shows, and books have featured these cars in their stories, and we're always left wondering how awesome it would be to actually see them in real life. Imagine going from one place to another at super fast speeds and without ever getting stuck in traffic. Imagine seeing flying cars everywhere in the sky. It would feel like living in the future, a future that we would all like to materialize as soon as possible. Well, that's exactly what Uber plans to do. Through concentrated efforts and years of planning, the world-renowned company wants to actually make flying cars a reality, and they're all set to achieve this goal with their flying taxi service. In today's video, we'll take a look at how Uber plans to roll this out and just how much of an impact it'll have on the world. But before we start, make sure you smash that like button and subscribe to our channel for more awesome tech videos like this. Now, let's get started. The idea is pretty self-explanatory. You would hire an Uber flying taxi from the app, get on it, and get off at your desired destination. It's an exciting vision that a lot of people around the world would love to experience. In 2019, many news outlets reported that Uber had joined hands with a secretive startup called Joby Aviation. It's a California-based aerospace company and has been working on developing electric flying cars for more than 10 years. These cars are slated to be vertical takeoff and landing cars, much like what we see in the movies. Uber entered into a partnership with the startup with an aim of launching a flying taxi service as early as 2023. It wanted to build a taxi service that was fast, clean, and reliable. Joby's CEO, Jobin Bevirt, had said that their flying cars would be 5 times faster than driving. They would also reduce urban congestion and accelerate the shift to electric vehicles. But Joby wasn't the only company that Uber had teamed up with. Before even signing them on, they had already partnered with 6 other aerospace companies, including Jaunt, Embraer, Pipistrel, Karam Aircraft, Aurora Flight Sciences, and Bell. This shows how invested they were in their plan, both in terms of money and effort. In early 2020, news broke out that Uber had partnered with Hyundai for their electric flying taxi project. This was significant news because Hyundai was an established brand and is considered a heavyweight in the industry. So its involvement was seen as a ray of hope that such a service could really see the light of day. Hyundai even came up with a prototype that they displayed at the Consumer Electronics Show back in 2020. The flying car looks sleek, kind of like a mix between a drone and a very small plane. Essentially, it looked like a flying pod, which is what we can expect from other companies' designs as well. Hyundai's prototype was an eVTOL as well, which stands for Electric Vertical Takeoff and Landing. The car could fly at a speed of up to 180 miles per hour, and the flying altitude ranges between 1,000 and 2,000 feet. However, the range was not that great, which clocked in at 60 miles. This has been a problem with electric vehicles in general, and when it comes to flying cars, we can only imagine their power requirement. The prototype was a 4-passenger model, which requires a human pilot. However, the company aims to turn it into a fully autonomous flying car at some point in the future. To reduce the noise that's typical of a helicopter, Hyundai included multiple small rotors and propellers around the airframe. So even though the rotors are small, they can work in conjunction with each other to provide the necessary thrust, all while making the flying car much quieter than a helicopter. This strategic partnership will see Uber handle the aerial rideshare network, while Hyundai will produce and manage the flying cars. The companies expect their service to go live in 2028, which is actually quite achievable. When everything seemed to be going the right way, Uber hit a roadblock last year. The company was under pressure from investors to turn profitable, and the executives thought it best to focus on their core business rather than to spread themselves thin. As such, they handed over their flying car project, called Elevate, to Joby Aviation in late 2020. They also invested $75 million into the startup and agreed to become partners when Joby's flying cars hit the market. Once Uber's flying taxis take to the skies, things will never be the same as far as personal transportation is concerned. There are so many advantages of such a service that it's mind-blowing just thinking about it. Let's take a look at some of the most important ones. The first advantage is that medium to long duration distances will seem short. That's because flying cars can travel from point A to point B instead of having to take roads that don't go straight to the destination. As such, travel times are cut down dramatically. Going by Joby's CEO words, if the flying taxis are 5 times faster, an hour's ride will only take about 12 minutes. This is huge. All that time saved can be used for other more important things. Another advantage is that when Uber's plans for autonomous taxis will materialize, flying taxis will be even safer than the ones on the ground. That's because the AI systems driving them will keep improving themselves until it's far better than a human being. This has been demonstrated by Tesla's self-driving cars in recent years. Yet another benefit that a lot of people will love is that there's no traffic jams in the air. That's because the sky is not bound by the rules of two-dimensional roads. If there are a lot of flying taxis ahead of you, the system could automatically fly you above them. This again ensures faster travel. But there's more. No more traffic jams means a reduction in overall pollution. The cars are themselves fully electric, so they won't produce any toxic gases. So when more people start to choose these cars, the pollution that would otherwise happen will get reduced. Another advantage that's specially geared for the manufacturers is that once a working design is finalized, the infrastructure cost is not that big. You don't need to build roads or bridges in the sky. Companies will just have to build helipad-like structures on buildings throughout the city. These will act as the designated takeoff and landing spots. All of these benefits sound amazing, but it's worth noting that Uber's flying taxi service still has a lot of hurdles to overcome. That's just how technology works, and as the saying goes, you can't stop an idea whose time has come. From the looks of it, flying cars are long overdue, but Uber will have to solve a lot of problems to make them a reality. The first one is to build a robust network of flying taxis and infrastructure on buildings. This includes using the best design possible to maximize efficiency. Another challenge will be on the regulatory front. Whenever something new comes up, regulators are usually skeptical. Then, when the innovators showcase how their technology can be used for good and how the risks can be minimized, rules and regulations are made to allow them. The third challenge is that of safety. There's a lot of fear among people that flying cars could be really dangerous, both for the passengers and for people on the ground. If a vehicle malfunctions, life and property could both be at risk. It's going to be interesting to see how Uber will work around these issues. But if history is anything to go by, you can expect them to be overcome. It's just a matter of time. And with our current rate of advancement, that time might not be far away. The first test runs are supposed to happen in 2023, and we can all hope that by the end of this decade, flying taxis will become a part of our everyday lives. What do you think about Uber's flying taxi service? Can you see this project succeeding? And if so, would you feel safe taking one of these taxis in your city? Let us know what you think in the comments section below. As always, if you enjoyed today's video and you want to see more, make sure you hit that subscribe button to stay updated on all of our latest videos. Other than that, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.